Hello and welcome back to another video on Snowflake. In this video, we are going to focus on the topic of access control privileges and kind of digging into an example of how security works, specifically as it entails roles and objects in terms of which roles have access to certain objects, how hierarchies work, stuff like that. Roles. So at a high level, as it says here, roles are entities to which privileges on objects can be granted and revoked. They're assigned to users to allow them to perform actions. A user can be assigned to multiple roles. This is important here. Roles can also be granted to other roles, creating a hierarchy of roles. And this is actually what they recommend and what you'll see oftentimes how this ends up working out. So as an example here, just in terms of a visual look, here's what the hierarchy looks like. And here are where the custom roles come into play. All of the permissions for a lower level role is inherited by the one above it. So in this case, account admin being at the top is actually inheriting everything below it. In this case here, if we look at, let's say, this custom role here, the second one, inherit everything from this first custom role as well. And then this third one would inherit both this and this one. High level, that's what's going on. So let's walk through some examples and I'll show you what that looks like in Snowflake itself. And hopefully we'll get you started and you can start to work with this on your own. We are going to create a role hierarchy. In this example, what we'll do is we'll create three roles. We'll create an analyst role, which will have the lowest amount of privileges. We'll create a developer role, which will inherit this analyst role. Plus we'll give it another permission to read another database that we have. And then we'll also create a third one, which is the CI role. That's going to include developer, which in turn also includes analyst, as well as we'll give it something else. So at a high level here, from lowest to more privileges, and then eventually you'd get up to account admin, similar to what we see here. Think of this as analyst, developer, CI, something like that. So let's get started. Let's just see, you know, what this looks like and work through it, and hopefully it will make more sense as we go about and you can start to think of different scenarios where you might want to use this. Currently, I'm logged in as the account admin, so I have permissions to everything. I'm the very top of that hierarchy. There's nothing that I cannot see here. So just to give an overview of what this looks like, here are some of the tables and schemas and whatnot. In terms of warehouses, we have a few here that we'll use. Let's create this analyst role, start to add some permissions and see what changes. First, I'll make sure I'm set as the account admin so that I have permissions to create these things. Create this role using the create role statement here. Now let's verify that this is here and there's no grants associated to it. A lot of these statements here in Snowflake are pretty straightforward, which I appreciate. It makes it a little easier to understand exactly what these permissions are doing. Now, right now I don't have visibility to this role right now. I don't see it as an option. And that's because my user is not assigned to this role. So let's go ahead and do that. Now I should be able to use this role. And see, now I can switch to role analyst. But if you look over here now, if I refresh this, you can see there's no permissions. There are no warehouses to pick from. This role really has nothing with it. So let's give this role permission to use the dev warehouse. To grant usage on a warehouse called dev warehouse, which is one that I have, to this role. Now, if we go back to using this role, we can see that this is now an option, but we still don't have any access over here to any of the databases. So let's go back to the account admin and you can see now that this more stuff is popping. And you can see as I switch, more things are popping back up. Let's grant usage on the DemoDB staging schema, which we don't have to, if I refresh, we can see that that's here. We want to give it to the analyst role. So we'll grant usage on that and we'll give select to all tables in that schema as well. So let's hop back into that role. So now I've switched back to here through this statement. And I can see here, I have access now to staging and I should be able to select from this table because I've given that permission. So again, I'm running as analyst. If I run this query, I can see the results. Let's compare, let's hop back and forth here. So we're currently analyst. If I go back to account admin and refresh, there's a lot more. Back to analyst. And again, it's trimmed down. Let's show the roles. We can see the specific grants now that are associated to this role. And because my user is tied to this role, my user has visibility to use this role and then all of the permissions that come along with it. One other thing to note, I know we briefly touched on the usage and select and these things here. All of this is available to understand through the documentation. You can see what different types of privileges call for, the different descriptions for them, and you can see exactly what that entails. I'm not going to get into that because, you know, it's just, that's a lot to cover in one video. So now we have one role. We have the analyst role. Let's create a second role called developer that will inherit all of the roles of analyst, but then we'll also give it a couple more privileges as well. Go back as the account admin role. We'll create this developer role. We can see currently there are no privileges at all. It's just like the analyst role was when we created it initially. It's basically just a placeholder. It's empty. We will assign my user to this role. I should be able to access this role, and I can. If I refresh, now you can see this is back to very basic placeholder, default databases and schemas, nothing else. Now, in addition to giving this to myself, we mentioned that roles can also be assigned to other roles. And this is how you create that hierarchy of inheritance. So what I'm going to do is use the account admin role again and grant the role analyst to the role developer, meaning I'm going to give developer all of the roles that we just gave to analyst as well. So now if I go back to using this role, I should be able to see the same things as analyst, and we do. We can see this here, and we would have select privileges as well. Now let's give some additional privileges on another database to give some additional, you know, privileges to this developer role. I will run all three of these, and now if we use the developer role, refresh, we now have access to this database and this schema and table. If we go back to analyst, we don't have that anymore. Account admin, everything. We see everything. Back to developer, analyst. So you can see it was pretty easy to inherit all of that and then add on top. That's the beauty behind how this works. Show the grants to the analyst role, and now let's show the grants to the developer role, and we can see all of these additional things here. Another thing I'll point out here is granted by, you see that this says Fivetran role. We didn't actually touch that at all here, but the reason that for these objects here, this says granted by this is because that is the owner of those objects. So you can see owner here is Fivetran role, but sysadmin here for the database. That's because when I originally created these tables, it was created by that role, the Fivetran role. That's the only reason that's there. Just like account admin, we created the role of the analyst by account admin. So therefore they granted us as a developer that role as well. So it's based on who the owner is for this here. Lastly, we'll create the CI role that will have a little more privileges as well. So we'll go through the same thing here, create the role, prove that there's nothing there, assign my user to it, prove that we can log in as it, and we can. Now let's grant developer to CI. And again, this means that CI is going to inherit all of the permissions of developer, which in turn is also inheriting all the permissions of analyst. So really this is getting everything below it. Now if we use this CI role, we can see we have currently, we haven't added anything else, everything exactly as the developer role would have. Let's go back to account admin and assign some additional privileges here. We'll give permissions to a different database, and we'll also give insert and update. We're not going to actually do that here, but just for the sake of example. Now let's compare the roles now. If we go in a CI, we can see we have visibility now to this database, my first DB, as well as the demo schema. If we go back to developer, we lose that one. And if we go to analyst, we lose the Fivetran. And account admin, everything. So again, going up the ladder, let's start at analyst with this, developer, CI. Now as account admin, one final thing here is we'll look at the difference in the grants altogether. So this is analyst, developer, we have a little bit more. CI, a little bit more as well. And you can see developer, inheriting, analyst. So you can kind of follow the breadcrumbs in terms of what's included in those roles. And what I think is nice about that is that means you don't have to assign the same privileges multiple times, because you just can assign it to one level of the hierarchy. And then as you inherit it, you don't have to do it again. It just brings that into the next role. The last thing I'll say is we went through this whole exercise here using actual SQL syntax in the worksheet here itself. But another option here is to use a tool that does infrastructure as code, something like Terraform, that actually can allow you to manage your permissions in various files so that you can source control it. You know exactly what all of the permissions are at any given time, and you can quickly redeploy that exact same environment with the same exact permissions across the board by just, you know, a simple Terraform apply in that case. If you're interested in Terraform, there are some other videos on this channel that can walk you through the basics of how to get started with that and how to use it specifically on Snowflake. So that'll be it for this video. I really just wanted to show you the basics of how this works, because this, I think, is pretty fundamental to setting up your environment. So as always, thank you for watching. If you found it helpful, please like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and I'll see you at the next one. Thank you.